Come, beat the heat at LAist's Ice Cream Social. We'll be talking with some of LA's most inventive ice cream makers, and we'll all get to taste their delicious creations. July 31st at the Crawford. Tickets at LAist.com/events.
Hi, this is Larry Mantle.
And I'm Desmond Mantle.
And we have a podcast, Passing the Mantle.
I grew up listening to my dad host Air Talk, and now I get to join him.
We'll talk about many issues from our different generations.
Subscribe to Passing the Mantle from LA's studios, wherever you listen to podcasts.
I mean, I'm gaining all these new friends, gaining all these really cool women to be a part of my life, and I don't take that for granted at all.
This is How to LA, the podcast that helps you discover something new. I'm Brian De Los Santos. Today, I want to talk about run clubs and really how they foster LA culture and community. And folks might view it as a cute thing to do nowadays, right? Put on some colorful shoes, get some cool glasses, and the latest athleisure fit. Online, it seems like everyone is talking about running clubs. Some people, like on TikTok, Instagram, or X, are even saying it's the new dating app.
I will never come on here and beg for anything, but I will beg for this. Yesterday, I saw the hottest group of men running. I'm sure it was a running club. What is the name? How do I join it? Let me know!
But there's more to it, at least here in Los Angeles. Our associate editor, my colleague, and our special resident marathon runner, Aaricka Washington, says, well, of course, it's about health and community first. And she's also a run club member herself. Aaricka has been looking into running clubs that were founded by Black, Asian, and Latino folks, and how they offer an inclusive, safe space for Angelenos, and why they are growing more popular. Hey, Aaricka.
Hey, Brian.
All right, Aaricka, before we get into run clubs, I want to know, as a runner yourself, I know you're always setting new goals. So what do you have planned for at the moment?
Yes, so Brian, I'm running my first world major marathon on October 13th in Chicago.
Oh, wow. Come on, Chi-Town.
I'm also running a relay race from Los Angeles to San Diego called No Shortcuts on October 25th with some folks from my run club, Keep It Run 100.
So it seems like you're busy right now, but I know you've been looking to cover this story because you're so involved with the running community. Tell me what led you into looking into running clubs across LA.
Yeah, so a lot of people, pretty much everybody, knows that I like to run. I love running. I've been running ever since I was in middle school and everything. So, you know, when I'm around my family members or when I'm around friends that are not in the running community, sometimes they express a little interest in running.
Mm-hmm.
But there's this intimidation factor. They're afraid that they're going to get left behind. I also seen that same sentiment on Twitter. And, you know, I'm seeing more and more people talk about run clubs on social media, about that intimidation factor, but also about the community that it can bring. And then we also got the dating part. But but let's focus on community, right? And so I'm in these conversations and I'm talking to people about the benefits that it has given to me. And I wanted to show people in my life, as well as in the social media spaces that I am in, that it is actually accessible.
Who are the people you spoke to?
So first of all, I'm really good with networking and meeting people. And so I was able to get the contacts for majority of the LA run clubs that are Black, Latino, or Asian led. And so I sent a survey out to over a dozen run clubs. I basically asked them questions about details about their run club, as well as like what has caused it to grow. All these run clubs have grown in the past few years. And then also what makes their space inclusive. And I learned that these clubs are really leading the way when it comes to providing a space for walkers and runners of all levels. Many of these run clubs have walking groups that walk 2 miles while the runners run 3. The run clubs I go to most often, Keep It Run 100 and Girl Gang Crazy, both have folks that either go at what's called a sexy pace, which is usually 13 to 14 minutes and up, slow runners and fast walkers pace. Or they just walk. All 13 of the run club leaders that filled out my questionnaire said that they don't leave anyone behind because the community is just that important.
That's interesting. I definitely have seen the run clubs floating around town. But tell me more about the responses you got. I also think that you spoke to community folks.
Yes. So I also talked to runners in the community like Chris Bordenave. Chris was born and raised in South Central.
Running was just so transformative. It sparked something in me and it transformed me. And, you know, it just changed my life.
He went from being the only black kid who ran on his cross country team in high school to being on billboards across LA in Nike campaigns. He manages Blue Ribbon Sports, Nike's first running specialty store. And in his role as part of Nike LA, he works with a lot of run clubs here. And he told me that he's seen this growth in run clubs over the course of the past 7-8 years, especially during the pandemic. More people wanted to find something safe that they could do outside.
People just wanted to be active and people wanted to be around other people. And I think that's where the trend started to really grow. And then once things started opening back up, everyone's like, yo, I've been doing this during the pandemic and I like what happened. I like, you know, the person I'm becoming emotionally, spiritually, mentally, physically.
And then I also talked to Mariah Dyson. She is the founder of Girl Gang Crazy.
Every time I have a conversation with anyone that comes to GGC, it feels divine. It feels like we were supposed to meet, and like every meeting that I have, I feel that way. But it's like, if nothing else from tonight, you can feel connected to the space. You feel connected to your own body and your own, you know, new power that you're finding.
She wanted to offer this inclusive space for women to not only train for a marathon, but also center themselves around their own mindfulness.
So, yeah, the numbers are growing organically. And it's fun to see because there's so many girls that they never thought they could do it. They never thought that running long distance would be a safe space for them. And because we have our, you know, our intentional pace groups that range from like beginner to even fast beginners, like joining us and feeling like, okay, I can push myself or I can pull it back today. There's always a pace and a space for everybody.
And we've been talking about folks who've been concerned about maybe not being fit enough to join a run club. But I know you talk to folks who have more experience with athletics too. What did you in particular hear from them?
Right. So I talked to Lauren Turner, who I run with at Keep It 100. She used to be a competitive varsity swimmer with the University of Texas at Permian Basin. She told me that she often ran 2 to 3 miles for cross training. But once she had her 3 sons, things changed for her. She had to develop a new relationship with her body and new identity. Her third pregnancy really hit her hard, and she was running a 16-minute mile, which is below average for someone with an athletic background. Mm. She wanted community and support from others. A friend of hers told her about Keep It 100, which ran in her Inglewood neighborhood, and the rest was history.
I was like, whoa, this is so many Black and Brown people ready to run at night in my neighborhood. This is so dope. I thought, like, wow, I feel so safe. And then I think at one point there was like music. And I was like, what is this? This is amazing. I have never had any experiences like that before, even as a competitive athlete. Usually there were a lot of rich, white, competitive people around, especially in the swimming world. So to see this in like long distance running was just really very beautiful.
She's not the only person that came to this realization that run clubs can foster community and help you take care of yourself.
You know, Aaricka, I think we cannot talk about competitive athletes and running without addressing the Paris Olympics that are kicking off right now. I feel like, you know, we've kind of seen some progress in the representation of Black and other athletes of color, like Sha'Carri Richardson. Her magazine spreads and her running athleticism just come to mind. But it hasn't always been this way in the overall running community, at least in media. I know you also looked into the racial disparities in the running community. What did you learn through your reporting?
There are still major racial issues in the running community. Around the time I started training for my first 10K, white men killed a 25-year-old Black man named Ahmaud Arbery, who was running in a Georgia neighborhood in 2020. After that hate crime, Run With Maud kind of launched, and that was a movement to get more people running. According to a recent survey from the Running Industry Diversity Coalition, runners of color have reported feeling significantly less safe at trail and road races than white runners. Earlier this year, a Black-led running club filed a lawsuit against Boston Marathon organizers for discrimination during the 2023 race. And then there's been a growth in diverse run clubs. Of course, there's always been run clubs around. LA Luggers has been in existence for decades, But 13 of the most prominent Black, Asian, and Latino-led run clubs in LA County have sprouted in the past 11 years, according to the Run Club Leaders survey responses. Seven of those run clubs surveyed were founded in the past 7 years.
We're going to take a quick break, but when we're back, we're going to talk about how you can get involved hitting the pavement with a local run club. Hey there! You ever feel like it's stressful to get to downtown LA? With Foothill Transit's express lines, downtown Los Angeles is closer and easier to get to than you think. Express buses make limited stops to get you into downtown quicker, and they let you ride in the I-10 express lanes so you can skip lots of stressful LA traffic. Less stress? Count me in. Are you ready to start going downtown the smart, relaxing way? Find a Foothill Transit Express bus stop in your neighborhood today at foothilltransit.org/express.
Support for LAist comes from Quality Start Los Angeles, sharing resources to help families teach children more than one language from birth. Speaking more than one language can help give children more of everything, not only job opportunities in the future, but also more self-confidence, success in school, more things to read, and more friends to talk to. You can find dual language learner resources in 6 languages, including Spanish, Armenian, Khmer, Korean, and Vietnamese at QualityStartLA.org.
Aaricka, I have to admit something to you. I attempted to get into the habit of running back in like 2015 with Blacklist LA, which you spoke to, by the way. But it didn't happen just because, I don't know, I didn't have a habit back then. Now, I do love my gym sessions and I like going to the gym, you know, 5 times a week. What are some of the tips that you would say to folks, whether it is people that told you from the run clubs or you yourself as a runner? Like, what have you learned?
Yes. So Lauren and Chris both gave me really good tips, and I also agree. So we're all saying this to everybody. But the first one I'll say is that Lauren suggested doing 10-minute runs at whatever time is convenient for you. You might have kids, you may have dogs and people that you got to take care of or things you have to do. But if you could take out 10 minutes of your day to just run a little bit. And it could be a nice little jog, you know, just to make sure your heart is going and you're, you know, staying on top of your fitness. Also, Chris told me that when he first got into long distance running with a run club, it was kind of intimidating for him. So he suggested walking. Start walking first for like 20 minutes to keep your body active and start doing that like 3 times a week.
And something that I learned from you, Aaricka, I would say, is that you started within a community group. Like, you sought out somewhere that you could, it was close to your parents' house, it was close to your house, somewhere that was not too far, so you didn't put an excuse, and that's how you started connecting with Keep It Run 100, is because they were in the community you already interacted with, right? So I think that's another tip that I got from you, is like, keep it in your community.
Yes, and sometimes we just got to be brave. I know it can be very hard to come up to people that you don't know and, you know, you don't know what their fitness levels are. But sometimes you just got to be brave because, you know, I'm going to be honest. I've been a part of Keep It Run 100 for 2 years. And there are still times I get nervous coming to run club because it's like, ooh, okay, got to talk. Yeah. But afterwards, I feel so good because I built those connections and because I met new people. I'm still meeting new people that come out to run club. And I'm talking to my friends, people that I've grown and built relationships with. So I challenge everybody to take a step out of your comfort zone, try out one of these run clubs, and let me know how it went. Okay.
And you actually did build a resource for people for your digital story. So if folks out there are listening to this and want to get involved in their local run club, maybe one that's geared towards women or towards Latinos or towards Asian folks, you do have a list of inclusive run clubs. But give us a little bit of taste of what you found and what they said about these run clubs. Like, who are they? What are they doing out there?
The great thing is, in my list, these run clubs are all over LA. There's Koreatown Run Club in K-Town, South Central Run Club, Compton. And I know these folks. They're great. There are also affinity run clubs, like Black Men Run Club, and there's women's spaces and even a run club for mothers. When you look at these run clubs on Instagram, that's where most of them, you know, talk about the next events or what they're doing. You'll notice that there's all kinds of people that are running and in a part of this, all different shapes, sizes, and shades.
All right, Aaricka, well, thank you so much for bringing your reporting back to How to LA.
Thank you, Brian.
Alrighty, folks, that is it for us today. I'm curious to know, what do you think of run clubs? Are you involved in one? Do you want to give a shout out? Let me know what you think at howtola@secpr.org. That is our team email, and we read every single one of them. So let me know what's up. Get in touch. Alrighty, y'all, that's it for us today. We'll catch you next time. This episode was produced by Monica Bushman. Our Hot to LA team also includes Aaricka Washington, Evan Jacoby, Megan Botel, and Victoria Alejandro. Our executive producer is Megan Larson. Our engineer is Hazmik Pagosian. Our intern is Veronica Daniel. And I'm your host, Brian De Los Santos. Support for this podcast is made possible by Gordon and Donna Crawford, who believe that quality journalism makes Los Angeles a better place to live.
LAist and Show and Tell present An Evening with David Sedaris. The humorist, comedian, author, and radio contributor will take the stage at the United Theater on Broadway to share insights, read from both published and unpublished work, and host a live Q&A with the audience, followed by a book signing. It's Saturday, November 16th at the United Theater. Tickets and information at laist.com/events.